Kristen.
Hey, this is Mars and Kristen talking with the dead milkmen.
Hi, Mars. Hi, Kristen.
Hi,
Joy.
Hey.
Thanks for bringing us the drugs. Hi, Joy.
Oh, hey, no problem. They're free anyway.
Oh, look, a roach.
Wow. No, run, no. Run.
I'm sorry.
Well, hey, it's totally not like it's Greenpeace is going to have your balls for
Oh, all right. Sorry. We're the environmentally unconscious station.
Oh, that's good.
All right.
That's still alive.
Oh, definitely.
It's still alive. It crawled in here.
All right.
That's a new one.
Maybe that's another one.
We can have roach race. Station with the environmental club, and the manager can come out.
Good. Oh, sorry. It's like crawling right over.
I know.
There it is.
That's
she fun.
I know. That's so cool.
Livestock.
Okay, as I was saying, we're talking with HB Hovercraft, Butterfly Fairweather, Dave Blund, Dean Clean of the Dead
Milkmen. Oh, it's a new year. We all have new names.
Yeah.
Oh, you do? What are the new names?
Dean Clean is my name.
Okay.
I'm now Dave Blund.
Okay.
I'm still HB Hovercraft. All his names are now spelled with a silent P at the end.
Okay.
And I'm Butterfly Fairweather until further notice.
The Wolf Boy.
All right, no problem. So does it get confusing when your names are noted differently on all your albums?
We hope so. No.
We recognize each other at practice. Hey, that's fine. Only when people yell insults at me. Look, there's another roach! Yes!
Hey, watch out!
Hey,
all right, roaches. Okay,
there's a lot of roaches.
So what are your real names, or is that like a Batman type secret?
That's like a Batman type secret.
That's something I don't mind talking about, because I don't see there's any purpose. I'm going to eventually use my real name.
I can't spell my real name.
When I make one, it's good.
Neither can we, so we said he had to change his name because we couldn't spell his name.
It was always getting misspelled, yeah. And we have all these contracts where his real name is misspelled.
There's a beer named after him in German.
Yeah, that's all we'll tell you.
There's a beer with Mike in a few minutes.
Oh, hi, Mr. Budweiser.
This is Mr. Coors Light. Monty beer.
Mr. Killian's.
Yeah.
All right, do you consider yourselves a political band, like maybe early U2 or...
I was a U2 spy plane pilot.
I like U2.
They get worse.
That's a good question, though. I mean, it's just like, I thought early U2 and then us.
But I consider everything is political. Debbie Gibson is political in the sense that, oh, there they are. God bless.
But currently,
you're political. You're in my will.
It'll also keep the roaches from walking across the table.
Exactly. Right. And then, I mean, we can always dump beer on it. Light them on
beer
fire.
Anyone?
Yes.
What was the question again?
Political, like early.
Oh, yeah, political.
I think Dave answered that question.
By cackling like a woman.
Oh, yeah, I guess I'll just hold it.
Thank you.
Cool.
Oh, my.
Beer wow. Aplenty.
Variety of beer.
All right, yes. That's just what I need.
I think we're political, yes.
Political?
Yes, I think everything is political. It's just a different way you view political. Like I say, music like Debbie Gibson and stuff like that is political, but it's a different type of politics. It's the politics of, you know, don't think.
The sexual politics.
Yeah. Yeah, well, Madonna is actually,
underclass.
Well, all like fine. Satirical looking at political. It in a socioeconomic sense. I mean, it's
I think we are a political band, yes.
How long has the band been together?
It'll be 10 years this July.
10 years.
In July.
That's pretty good. That's a decade.
Yeah.
Have you decayed ever over the last decade?
No, we have not become the Dead Kennedys.
I think we should I'm trying to get this piece of wood out of my eye.
Oh,
isn't there like a penalty for something like that?
But we've been decomposing.
We've been aging.
Rapidly. I want to call the next album Fear of Time, because there's this, across the street from me, there's this really great antique store, and they have this beautiful desk, and it says, quality does not fear time, so I'm going to call our album Fear of Time, or it's like lack of quality. What's that?
Wow. It's Engelbert Humperdinck, isn't it?
Yeah,
it is
blood all over me.
Is he a big influence
That's
on
unlikely
you?
Name.
He doesn't look like that anymore.
Oh, okay.
What was the question?
Where are we?
Artwork on the album, do you do that?
I do the covers mostly, but we all do little drawings and stuff for the inside.
Get your children. It's like a big mural. We learned the idea in the 70s from Jim Baez.
I could see how
I
that could
think
happen.
Now, because I got a beer in my hand. And a Yule log in my eye.
Yeah.
What
could
odd.
Do the next one.
We have arts and crafts class every month, and, you know,
that's
usually
right.
come up with a good album.
We tried using sculptures, but it just, you know, threw out 3D CDs. Was,
it would push up the price of the CDs.
Correct.
And we had to package them in long boxes. What?
Pop out.
I think you should make longer boxes, like a 6 foot long box.
Extra long box.
Made out of wood.
celebration of the tree.
Redwood. Redwood, yeah. Redwood, but like a dead
Brazilian rainforest wood.
Like 1,000-year-old redwoods. There
that's
you
right.
go.
Yeah.
And comes with your own.
Well, that's where folk guitars come from. Remember, folk guitars are always out there singing about cutting down trees, but what are they playing? A wooden guitar.
There
I use go. All plastic in my
stuff. So that
petroleum
way it
products.
Just won't
petroleum
decay.
Well, that way my grandchildren still use it.
You can recycle it, maybe.
Yeah, I would say my grandchildren still use the equipment I'm using now. In fact, they'll probably be paying for it.
Among
wouldn't,
the
it be, wouldn't it be cool if everybody carried around their own personal paper shredder?
That would be cool.
I just wanted to...
That would be cool also if everybody had an invisible robot friend. My robot friend isn't invisible. I mean, let's get real, okay? Jeez.
What do you think this is, the 90s?
Mm-hmm.
Well, among the four of you, how many sets of Ginsu knives do you own?
I don't have any.
No.
I don't have any. I'm not allowed to have any cutlery in my home. But I do have a Swiss Army knife that saves my life every day.
I do have a Swiss Army knife, too.
All right.
I have one of those magic coupon cutters that only cuts the top page of the paper.
Wow.
That's
not bad.
How'd you get that?
I don't know.
That's neat.
I think I bought it at
I have a letter opener cutter that, you know, you just slide along. It has, like, a razor blade in it.
That's not a knife. This is a knife.
Do you guys have any problems going out in public? Can people say, you know, hey, aren't you guys...
Only people yell occasionally, you suck. And
then, yeah. Philadelphia is like, hey, get out of town. We thought we were, you thought we were on tour.
But generally, no, we're not that big or important, so it's okay.
People always think I'm going to shoplift in stores, and some guy always follows me around. It's not nice.
Whenever I go into the bank, the guard always undoes the flap on his holster. But other than that,
like Jimmy
generally, yeah, but I think that would be happening to me no matter what I did for a living. Because that happened to me before I was in a band. But actually, I've always sort of been in a band. But that's kind of long. I've been in this band for life. I was born into this band.
Okay, this is a really important question now. If you had
those other questions weren't important, why?
Oh, they're all important.
Okay.
They're all
important.
This one is
special. Wait, I have a question. Do you think it would be cool if, like, everybody in the world shaved their eyebrows off?
These are fake, actually. They're pasties.
Okay.
Do you think girls respect a guy less if he lets himself be kissed? Because although girls go out with me, they always seem to marry the other kind of guy.
Words of wisdom. Something to ponder.
Anyway, what were you going
to
ask?
Okay, all right. If you had the opportunity to kill any cast member of 90210, who would it be?
Oh.
How would you do it? And where
Shannon,
would you hide?
Shannon Doherty.
And where would you hide the body?
Shannon Doherty, because she spoke at the... I used to think she was attractive until she spoke at the Republican convention, and I thought, it's time Shannon has an accident.
Well, how would you do it?
Well, how would I do it? You know, I would do it with a pork chop. You know how? And then I would serve the pork chop to the detectives that came to do the Kelly Hitchcock style. Yeah, but I would store the body in George Bush's trunk. So as he's leaving the White House, I would call up and I'd say, you know, he's got something in the trunk. And then they blame George
Bush. He's stealing pens.
Yeah, he's stealing pens. And then, like Nixon, whenever Nixon would leave the White House, they'd count the silverware. Well, it's the same thing. I'd say, you know, get him. And then that's what I would do with the body. It would be a perfect crime.
Cool.
I have Bob Forrest do it.
Yeah. Oh. Which do you prefer? Smooth or chunky peanut butter?
Smooth.
Smooth?
Smooth.
I like chunky.
Chunky.
Just one more thing.
Either or either or.
Either or either or.
I do have a specific brand.
I saw Jason Priestley drinking, getting back to 90210.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's right, yes.
Yeah, I went to a bar in
LA. Is he even 21?
Oh, yeah. He's 21 two times over.
Oh, that's true.
Right.
Okay.
I can't wait till I'm 30 so I can play a freshman on 90210. No, I went to a friend of mine and I went to a bar, and it was a social club on Sunset, and we were drinking, and I was talking about, like, we had a really cool evening earlier. I said, well, it's a shame because we're just going to coast for us the evening. He goes, oh, yeah, look next to you. And there's Jason Priestley standing there. And I went to knock out his hand. Brandon, you know last time you drank, you wrecked Mondale, and you know that Dylan's in AA, and geez, Brandon, like, what's your problem? And then every time Steve drinks, he plays that Alky role. But then, you know, and Kelly's mom was an Alky. That show's chock full of Alkies. I wish the Walshes would put down a few.
The thing I hate is, like, they're supposed to be in high school still, and I'm in college, and they look, it's like, they're so much older than me, and I'm in college. And
yeah. My favorite line from 90210 was, the guy's supposed to be a 17-year-old boy. He's in bed with this girl, and the girl's coming on to him and goes, "I can't make love unless I'm in love." I say, when I was 17 years old, I'd have done it with a tree, a turtle crossing the road. Oh, look, not holding a tree.
Put some realism in there. Yeah. Special episode, 90210, Brandon is caught masturbating.
That was really good. They talk about that on Seinfeld, but they never talk about, you know, masturbating on 90210. And teenagers are constantly, "Brandon, you've been in there for an hour. Come on out." I think Dylan got those diapers.
We can see for different. Oh, my God, Brandon.
Originally, they were on his palms.
Hey. There you go. Oh, yes, a controversial question.
Note the difference between before and after I start drinking.
Okay.
But.
What are your three favorite words? It could be any word, like three words together or separate.
I love you. Boil sugar peanuts.
You big queen.
Theophilin waterfly.
Madagascar jumping rat.
I have one of those.
Systematic xylophone pukey. now we have to say words again.
If you want to, we can make it a
bulbous Protestant lobster.
Boy,
okay. Sonic Youth disbanded. Those are my three favorite words.
I already forgot Mystery Science Theater.
Mystery Science Theater, thank you. But still, Sonic Youth disbanded. The most beautiful three words in the English language.
By the way, these questions are really good.
Also known as Rich Kids Go Home, Sonic Youth disbanded. Drum roll, please, John Bonham, Bobby Dick!
When you go to McDonald's and order a hamburger, what do you do with the pickles?
I eat them. I love the pickles on McDonald's.
Really?
Yeah, first of all, I don't go to McDonald's.
Okay.
I do.
I would eat the pickles. Force. I would ask for more pickles.
But if I did, I would eat the pickles.
I don't eat at McDonald's, but I like pickles.
I go to McDonald's for both of them. I live on garbage and alcohol.
Oh, yeah.
I like dill pickles.
Definitely. Okay, what would you do with a wayward armadillo?
Well, you know, armadillos are the only mammals other than human beings that carry leprosy. So I would just either heal that armadillo like I did in my past life before you fuckers nailed me up, or just ignore it.
Anybody else?
I'd ignore it.
What's the question again?
What would you do? How can an armadillo be wayward anyway?
Well, you never know. Maybe it's distraught.
I'd give him some nice warm soup and send him on the right way home.
All right.
Don't touch him.
Don't touch him.
We used to have the Playboy Channel on our old house down in Texas. It was really bad. We needed to fall asleep. We couldn't go to sleep. We'd watch the Playboy Channel and go right out. And they had this girl down in Texas for like the Playboy Centerfold thing, and she was naked chasing an armadillo. She caught it. She's like holding it. I was like, does she know about the leprosy that you can get from those? Leprous armadillo girl. Another three beautiful words.
Someone at the station brought a picture of it in, because I...
A picture of what?
Of an armadillo with leprosy.
Oh!
Hey! Alright.
What does it look like?
Common fact, I've
you wouldn't want to know.
I think I told you in 85.
April 17th?
Probably, I don't know.
Weren't you at the meeting when we discussed this?
Amarillo.
I missed that one.
Oh, jeez. Okay, if you could have sex with any one cartoon character, which one would you pick?
I'd go with Bugs Bunny.
When he dresses like a girl or just like plain?
I don't care, just plain.
I don't know, Daffy Duck's male and I'm doing the straight thing, so I had to pick a few. Oh, Betty Boop, I guess, would be
that's
a cartoon.
What I was thinking.
Yeah. Betty Boop, Jessica Rabbit.
Just one.
Oh, olive oil or olive
juice. Josie and all the pussy cats.
I never do just one.
I know one. What's the girl that hangs out with the Ninja Turtles?
April O'Neil.
April O'Neil, yeah.
There you go.
Any
cartoon women you'd like to
Betty
populate
Boop.
With?
Yeah, Betty Boop. My father used to always, when I was a kid, we used to always wonder about Popeye, because the old Popeyes are wonderful to watch. They're fluid, they're amazing.
Yeah.
And eventually Popeye got really static. But we used to watch the old Popeyes, and we used to wonder why Popeye and Brutus would fight over olive oil. I mean, there's not a whole lot there. And my father, one day, said, "Son, do you ever notice what other women they have to choose from? Sea Hag and Alice the Goon." And he said, "Son, when you get older, you'll understand closing time at the bar."
They're pedophiles.
My father's like this well of wisdom.
Not as good as Ken's father, though, was like 100 times more wise. Ken's father's just like this.
I have a friend named Ken, I just met his father. He's a mountain of wisdom.
Did you all grow up together, or did you kind of just, like, meet each other?
We all went to different schools together.
I met when I was asking him for change for $1.35.
Last week I couldn't spell drunk. Now I am one.
Oh, hey, where did you get your copy of Truck Stop Tart?
Oh, Truck Stop Tart. That's a good question.
That's a great
book. I got that in Baltimore.
Really?
Truck Stop Tart was fun, but the other one, the one where the girl gets whipped in the Soviet Union, was extremely unpleasant, even for me.
What about Naked Teenager on a Leash?
Naked Teenager on a Leash is a good book. Originally, I started buying these books. I got out to L.A., and I was reading them with, Gretchen from... Gretchen from
Mary Stanish.
Mary Stanish was heavily influenced. I read to her for a while, and Bob Forrest also... from Florence Monster enjoys my porno books. Like, I used to have tons of them. People used to give them to me. I used to have, like, the dog did Aunt Sally. I used to have a whole animal. She loved her puppy. I think pornography is one of the most beautiful things in the world. I think one of the most tragic organizations is Women Against Pornography, because most of the real pornography collectors I know are women, so it seems like kind of backwards.
So does pornography play a really big role in your playing? And
no, I don't own a whole lot of it. I used to have, like, tons, you know, like, people would give me these goofy books, but I don't, no, it's not this huge, you know, part of my life. I don't even think I own any. I think if you went through my house looking for pornography, I doubt it.
I have Stanley Kubrick's Lolita on tape.
Oh, there you go. There you go.
Carl Malden.
I guess
he screwed that up, because he made her, in the book, she's 12, and in the movie, she's 14.
It's a good movie, though.
Yeah, it's a good movie, mind you, but any Kubrick thing is a great movie, except for Barry Lyndon, which is... Chieftains did the soundtrack for Barry Lyndon, so that's good, but other than that, it's kind of unwatchable. Never cast Brian O'Neill on any film.
Yeah, I know. I second that one.
I think Siskel and Ebert both said he sucks the roof.
Two thumbs way down.
Siskel and Ebert say, sucks the roof!
Do you get tired of that?
Emulating your guitar style.
Do you get tired of people asking if you've ever smoked banana peels? I'm sure you've been asked that.
Yeah, I get
asked that all the time.
Yeah, we're at that.
And I've never smoked them.
No, because you get a headache, you don't get any. But I've smoked everything else, so it's okay.
We've gotten dried banana peels in the mail. I don't know if that's legal or not.
Huh.
But I didn't even try.
That's importing, exporting food.
Agricultural products through the mail.
I don't know. I thought you could only buy seeds through the mail. How would I know that?
Yeah.
But
you've been buying Morning Glory seeds through the mail, haven't you?
Oh yeah, exactly.
Do you have any indoor grow lights on?
Oh,
I know.
We'll talk later. Okay. See, if you could find out how and when you were going to die, but you couldn't change it, would you want to know?
Oh, definitely.
Really?
Definitely, yeah. I would definitely go, alright, now, because I want to pop a nut before.
Would you want to know?
Yeah, because I have a few things to take care of.
Oh, that's a blunder way of saying what I just said.
I mean, on the one hand, yeah, you could really, like, you know, you could do a lot of things then. You know, you could
get everything.
You know, you could take a lot of, like, really bad risks because it wouldn't happen, you know. But on the other hand, I rather like the mystery of it all, you know.
Well, see now, there's a girl I've been meaning to sleep with for about 6 years now, and we keep putting off. And I think if I knew, I'd just, like, excuse me, I've got to catch a train in about an hour, you know, and then.
Yeah, all aboard for the pearly gates.
Yeah.
Okay, this is an intellectual question.
Well, you do know when you're going to die and how. You're going to die in a few hours at my hands.
Oh, thank you.
Dissension among the bands. Oh, you can't get this anywhere else. We'll have
I'm
to
sell this.
I'm wearing this shirt.
Years now.
It's totally ruined everything today.
Yeah, this is an intellectual question. How many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop?
Well, the wise owl says three.
That's true, but he bit.
Well, I heard that.
He bites.
I really don't want
an owl that does that?
No control. The owls are not what they see.
Last time I sucked on, I was counting, and then I lost count.
Yeah, you actually did try that once, didn't you? We were in the van.
Just a couple of days ago.
Oh, really? Because we were in the van once, and you tried it.
I never liked Tootsie Pops anymore.
I never liked much candy, really. I was never much of a candy eater.
Really?
I never really do many things that are bad.
for me.
Except when you do sugar experiments.
Oh, yeah. I have a friend of mine who doesn't drink or take drugs, and when I visit her, I do sugar. And I didn't sleep for 4 days, and I just lived off sugar. And I started,
caffeine, too.
Caffeine. I was on the most incredible sugar caffeine rush and no sleep. I was totally nussed out. We're driving from San Francisco into Palo Alto, and I started thinking about how electrons move backwards and forwards in time. Therefore, Oliver Stone was responsible for JFK's death, since Oliver Stone made the movie about it. You follow that sort of logic?
Yeah.
So I was real happy about that. So that's the sort of thing you think if you don't sleep for 4 days and you eat a lot of sugar and drink a lot of caffeine.
If you could be a breakfast cereal, which one would you be, and what surprise toy would you have inside?
Count Chocula, and the surprise toy would be rusty barbed wire.
All right.
Oh, I do, actually. But kids love rusty barbed wire. I'm just giving them what they want. The more dangerous thing.
Bag of glass.
More, a bag of glass, yeah. Bag of sulfuric acid. Bag of rusty nails.
A Johnny Switchblade.
Mr. Mangler.
Anyone else?
Cereal. I think I'd be Pop-Tarts.
Pop-Tarts?
Not cereal.
That's more like, you don't put it in milk. Breakfast food.
Oh, right.
You're high.
I'd be, Fruity Pebbles, I guess.
What sort of surprise food? You know, that's believe it or not, that's what I asked Larry Lalonde of Primus the same question, and that's what he answered.
Oh, right. Oh, you been hanging out with Primus.
There you go. Hey.
I saw that over for you, too.
So did I.
They were good, but the audience didn't get them. We're all yelling, Primus suck! And I was like,
oh, yeah.
Why are you saying that? What?
It was horrible. It was horrible.
What, were you at the Philly show?
Yeah.
That's where I was. That's where I was. What day
I got to be right down front. I was right down, you know where they come out when they do the acoustic part? That's right where I was. That's you, yeah.
That's you.
I'm the girl with the big penis. You see me. No, I look out, I was like right in front. I thought, no, I could see Primus like really well. I totally lucked out in my seats. I was like dead center and about pretty much like right even where they came out.
The second night, because you were out of town the first night, right?
Yeah, it was second night.
I was at the second night too. Damn.
No.
Where were you seated? Where were you seated at?
I was in nosebleed.
Oh, I totally lucked out for that show. Oh, I was like, wow. Right, when I'm sitting there, and members of D-Light come out, and start dancing. I'm like, looking like standing next to me is like D-Light. It was pretty weird.
Cool.
And then I was right there when they come out and they sing like Satellite of Love, which I was singing in a bar the other night.
Good Lurie. Alright, what's your favorite Mary?
Did that.
Okay, what's
that? Vicki Lawrence, yeah.
Well, she must have covered.
Well, Vicki Lawrence did it on her talk show.
What's your favorite Barry Manilow song? I mean, this doesn't have to go any farther.
Mandy.
Mandy?
Oh, yeah.
Only Barry Manilow thing I like is the thing that Dennis Leary does about how he wants to cut off Barry Manilow's head and drink beer out of it. You write the songs, I'm the guy that drinks beer from your head.
Mandy, but then I found out it wasn't about mandrax and it's not fun anymore.
Okay.
It's about mandibles. Dean just gave up and left. I can't say I blame him.
It's kind of deteriorating.
Oh, okay, well, all right.
More beer I want. I got this. In order to put my sampler on the stand, I had to saw this piece of wood, and the piece of wood fought back like throwing a chunk of itself in my eye. I've been in immense pain.
See an optometrist.
I should see an optimist. They tell me I'm okay. Forget about it.
We only have two more questions. If you could add one member of the Partridge Family to your band, which one would it be?
Lori.
Lori? Really?
She isn't dead.
Which one? Danny, the little girl that plays tambourine.
The little girl that plays tambourine.
Really?
That's Susan.
I like
Susan.
That's Susan.
That's
Susan Crowe. No, Susan Crowe played Susan Logo. But
yeah.
Lori was played by Susan Day.
She'd be a lot of fun to have her.
I'd say Lori.
Really?
What about the little kid? He changed his name half.
Jeremy?
Well, no, he changed his body halfway through. He was a little dark-haired boy, and then he became a little...
With no explanation whatsoever.
I have an explanation for it. Chromosomes. Bad agent.
Okay, what's
contract negotiations?
There you go.
Damn it! I hold that band together. You know what I mean? He was
like
getting
drugs,
his big head. He was getting his big head. He was like, "Damn it! I hold this band together." Plus, I hear Keith was playing some of his drums on the records, and he got upset, like with Ringo.
Yeah.
So. He was good at scoring coke for Danny, though. That was all right. Joe met Danny Bonaduce.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, we don't know if we can tell the story, though.
Tell him where he
is. Oh, he is cool, yeah. He's walking around. In the red light district of Vancouver. Vancouver.
Vancouver.
Yeah.
He was walking around late at night for some reason.
And so was I. For another reason. I guess.
Hey.
I don't know which reason he was walking around. We didn't get into a heavy conversation.
Yeah. What's the weirdest question you've ever been asked?
Jeez. Hey, mister, would you please stop standing on my kid's head?
I Isn't that guy. More of a statement, though?
I don't know. My worst question, I guess, would be, is it in yet?
Somebody asked you that question.
No!
No comment here. Well, we have some lovely parting prizes.
Well, I have to tell you a story. I told everybody in the banner, but I wanted to put it on tape so it gets out there. I have a friend of mine. Actually, she's a friend of a friend of mine. We're sitting in a bar that night, and she told us a story about she was down in Mexico, and she slept with this guy with a really small penis, and he kept saying, muy pequeño, muy pequeño. She's like, sí, muy pequeño, which means very small. I just thought that was a lovely tale, and I wanted to share it with you.
All right, this has been The Dead Milkman.
Okay. Hello!
Hi.
Hello, hi.
I can't hear you over the other band.
Turn that racket down, would ya?
We're listening to WUMD.
In Baltimore.
If it were WOMB, it would be The Womb, and you'd feel like going back to it again and again and again.
Hey, you don't even know who we are. We're the Dead Milkmen.
I'm joining Primus.
Great. Oh.